about he said that we did really good eye contact determination work. He said a few of us like let the pig and him in the front. Our pigs were tired, didn't want to do anything, and so it was like a team effort. So.
You done good.
Thank you. I'm going to tell you something, folks. I enjoy judging hogs, but I really, really get a first-class charge out of working with good kids. You can let them rest. I got my mind made up. I just got to talk a little bit. My wife says, give me a microphone. I'm good for 10 minutes. There was one other time, I believe it was in Fannin Springs 2 or 3 years ago, that I got the gap down to 4 inches. And there was two pigs that came and met nose to nose. I believe that this young man over here could probably run with him on that. You got really good control. I tell you what I was looking for here was 12 to 20 feet away from me. Those of you that are going to be coming in the junior and intermediate, 12 to 20 feet is my comfort zone. Keep them moving. Don't let them stand still unless I tell you to. The gas pedal on these pigs, I've told these children all night long, if they want to make them go, the gas pedal is right here on the ribs. That's where you hit them to make them go. If you want to steer, it's on the side of the face. Don't hit them on the butt, because you know, my daddy, Sergeant Wiggly, would work on my attitude once in a while when I was a child. He grabbed that arm, and he'd draw back with that other arm fixing to give me that belt. What did I do? I tucked my butt up underneath me. When you hit these pigs on the rear end, they do the same thing. That butt goes up underneath them, that top arches up. We want that back to look just as straight and flat and pretty as can be. I throw dirt on these pigs. What was I looking for? Number one, I wanted to be clean the next time I looked at them. Number two, I prefer not to see you touching that pig. So when I walk away, I gave you a chance to do the deal. Now, the first thing I call on was eye contact. The second thing is don't get between me and that animal. Third thing is masterful control. Keep that animal moving. Keep him where I'm at. Go put him in front of me. You got one that's been hard to get around, and that's the young man. He will be your senior showmanship champion. When it comes to second and third, I tell you what, I'd love to take either one of you somewhere. I told a young lady a while ago, though, she was a senior, she cried on me, and that's the reason I had to hug her, because I can't take one of the young girls to cry. But she said it was her last year. Congratulations. Said it was her last year. Well, her pig gave out on her. Showmanship is a team effort. You got to have you and your partner work. Please don't cry. I'll be right there with you again. You got to have that pig working with you the whole time. I think we've had one or two that through the course of the day that have not wanted to work quite as well. So it comes down to some things that I really like. And here's what I think between second and third. I think I got one that's just really got me dialed in. I don't know that I've ever looked up, even when you didn't think I was looking. And I found you looking right back at me. And that little bit of eye contact difference being 100% of the time as opposed to 99.44 like Ivory Soap is going to be the difference between second and third. And lady here will be second, and lady here will be third. Sorting from first to third, it ain't gonna happen. These three are good enough that little bitty tiny things is what separates first and third, and also the reason some of these others didn't get to stay is because the heat that these three were putting out here. One more time, right? Young man didn't give it up, and he didn't want to stay. Okay? One more time, a round of applause for all your seniors and seniors.